Good morning and welcome to Sacred Heart Church. Please stand. Oh, and we're in the Breaking Bread number 62, Come Emmanuel.
Welcome to Sacred Heart Church. I'm Father Carlos Alvarez, your pastor. Today is the second Sunday of Advent, and we are offering the Mass for the following intentions: for Mary Abigail Pittman, Dorothy Sutak, Julian Roberto Fuentes and Julian Jose Fuentes, Marta Maria Cuevas, for the health of Luis Sanchez, as requested by Roy, for the deceased members of the Catholic Daughters, by the Catholic Daughters of America, Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810, for Eleanor C. Noriega, Teresita Mestes, okay, and for also Father Clement Lafferty, a Benedictine priest who served in our diocese and died on this date in 1985. For all the intentions that we hold in our hearts, united with the Sacred Heart of Jesus, placed on the sacred altar, we know that just as surely as bread and wine are offered and are transubstantiated in the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus, that our Heavenly Father hears and answers our prayers according to His will. We also continue to pray for Roy Avila on this ninth day of the novena, praying for his soul, and for Sandy Rivera, who was buried from Holy Name of Mary Church yesterday on the second day of novena, praying for her soul. And again, a special welcome to you if this is your first Sunday here, you're visiting this weekend, or a guest of one of our family members after Mass. I look forward to personally greeting you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries, we come before God with humble and contrite hearts. We do acknowledge our sins. We trust in God's infinite mercy. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie. Kyrie. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and of understanding, a spirit of counsel and of strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord, and his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Not by appearance shall he judge, nor by hearsay shall he decide, but he shall judge the poor with justice and decide aright for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Justice shall be the band around his waist, and faithfulness a belt upon his hips. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, with the little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall be neighbors. Together their young shall rest. The lion shall eat hay like the ox. The baby shall play by the cobra's den, and the child lay his hand on the adder's lair. There shall be no harm or ruin on all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with knowledge of the Lord, as water covers the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse, set up as a signal for the nations, the Gentiles shall seek out, for his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. May his name be blessed forever. As long as the sun, his name shall remain. In him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nations shall proclaim his happiness. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, whatever was written previously was written for our instruction, that by endurance and by the encouragement of the Scriptures we might have hope. May the God of endurance and encouragement grant you to think in harmony with one another, in keeping with Christ Jesus. Welcome one another then as Christ welcomed you for the glory of God. For I say that Christ became a minister of the circumcised to show God's truthfulness, to confirm the promises to the patriarchs, but so that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy, as it is written, "Therefore I will praise you among the Gentiles and sing praises to your name." The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. John the Baptist appeared, preaching in the desert of Judea and saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." It was of him that the prophet Isaiah had spoken when he said, "A voice of one crying out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths." John wore clothing made of camel's hair and had a leather belt around his waist. His food was locusts and wild honey. At that time, Jerusalem, all Judea, and the whole region around the Jordan were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. When he saw many Pharisees and Sadducees coming to his baptism, he said to them, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the coming wrath? Produce good fruit as evidence of your repentance. And do not presume to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our father.' For I tell you, God can raise up children to Abraham from these stones. Even now the axe lies at the roots of the trees. Therefore, every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I am baptizing you with water for repentance, but the one who is coming after me is mightier than I. I am not worthy to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand. He will clear his threshing floor and gather his wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
I spent my senior year of college, the first semester, in Cairo, Egypt. And an early graduation gift to me was a safari. So I went south and east to Kenya, and I was on safari. And I think in the last place where we did safari, there was an extended jeep, kind of with open sides. And it would fit 10 to 12 people, including the driver in the front. And so we had spotted lionesses, and the lionesses were hunting. And as we saw the lionesses, we drove up very close to the lioness. It was about as far as I am from Lisa. Okay, I'm in a jeep, and the lioness is there. And I'd never been to Africa. I'd never seen wild lionesses. I thought, okay, that lioness is going to have a big, tasty Thanksgiving and Christmas dinner with me, right? Wrong. That lioness and the other lionesses that were in the hunt were so focused on their prey, they didn't care about these human persons in the jeep. They weren't even aware of us. They were so attentive on their prey that they were stalking. So I was like, whew. You know, I was only, 21 years at the years old at the time, and I thought, be nice to live a little bit longer, not go down to lionesses. I thought about that experience, you know, my utter terror. I thought, this driver's crazy. What's he doing? I guess he doesn't really like us and he wants us to be prey for the lionesses. But no, he knew lionesses' behavior. The lion waits for the prey. The lionesses do all the hunting, okay? But They were amazing. It was incredible to be that close to wild animal and not have anything, not being any harm at all. So I thought about that experience in reflecting on today's scriptures. The lion will eat hay with the ox. The lion will eat hay with the ox. Now, I don't know if you've ever seen an ox, but in that semester in Egypt, the ox would be led by the side of the Nile River and along the Nile River by Egyptians. I still remember that word in Arabic, gamusa, an ox walking down the streets of Cairo near the Nile River. So I saw an ox and I thought, an ox and a lion together eating hay? Come on, really? But when you think about it, it really does speak about something important that we need to recall. First, we need to call the Garden of Eden, before our first parents, Adam and Eve fell. Before their original sin, not only were the human persons in peace, as this Chasuble says, Pax Latin for peace, not only were they at peace, but all of creation was at peace. All of creation was at peace. So another point in the history of salvation where that happens is with Noah and the flood. With Noah and the flood, the lion and the ox were eating hay next to each other, and no problem with Noah and the flood. And then there's another point in the history of salvation where that happens. We're getting ready to celebrate that in about 3 weeks. In the cave, when the Christ child was born, all the animals were there in peace. Now, normally in a cave, in a barn-like setting, they would normally be at peace, but not always. I'm a city boy, but I've been around animals enough to know that they're not always just copacetic, right? So those are examples of the fact of what happens in the human person also happens in nature. And so we have this image of this peaceful period between God and humankind that affects all of creation, including lions and oxes. So how do we get there is the question. How do we get there? St. John the Baptist in the Gospel tells us, repent. Repent. To repent means to change the way that we think. To repent means to disavow ourselves of sin and to live in a state of grace. So this is the invitation for us. John came saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It means the kingdom of heaven is near. The person of Jesus is near. And when we believe that, and when we act that way, and when we respond in a way that's pleasing to God, we'll experience that peace. You don't have to go to a safari and get near a group of lionesses hunting to experience that peace. Because honestly, it was first of all terror for me, and then it was calm, and then there was peace. But that peace comes when we renew the grace of our baptism. And how do we renew the grace of our baptism? In confession, repentance, reconciliation. Confession, penance, reconciliation. It's the three names for the same sacrament. And we'll have that opportunity tomorrow in Spanish, and we'll have that opportunity on Tuesday in English. Father Carl Warden, Director of Vocations for the Diocese of Pueblo, will be here at 6 o'clock Monday, 6 o'clock Tuesday. He'll give Mass with an extended homily, beautiful Advent themes, and after Mass, we'll hear confessions. On Monday, it'll be Father Carl, myself, Father Sergio, and Father Damian, all four of us hearing confessions in Spanish. On Tuesday, it'll be Father Carl, myself, Father John Farley, Father Eric, hearing confessions in English. When we open ourselves to this reality of the renewal of our baptismal grace, we find that peace that Isaiah speaks about that comes in the person of Jesus through baptism, through the renewal of our baptism by confession, through all the sacraments. My brothers and sisters, that's the invitation for us, to prepare ourselves for the coming of Christ in the season of Christmas, to make a good confession. How often should we go to confession? Holy Mother Church says we need to go to confession at least once a year. Holy Mother Church recommends we go monthly. St. Ignatius of Loyola recommended that his Jesuits go weekly. And St. John Paul II went to confession daily. And a reporter asked him, "Holy Father, why do you go confession daily?" He said, "The just man falls 7 times a day. I met John Paul II. Most of us knew him through the media. He was a holy man, and he went to confession daily. It's like, wow. I'm not saying you have to go to confession daily, but there's a great opportunity this Wednesday and Tuesday. Let's take advantage of it and really prepare our hearts for the coming of Jesus in the season of Christmas, okay? So you don't need to test your bravery by going near lionesses while they're hunting. It's a nice experience, but you don't need that adrenaline rush. Just come. Tomorrow night, come Tuesday night, come both nights. Experience this wonderful mission talk and the grace of our sacrament of confession, penance, reconciliation. And in that way, we're really expressing the hope that we hear about in the second reading in St. Paul's letter to the Romans. They talk about the virtue of hope. Hope is not only for the next life, but for this life. Hope. We'll experience that hope and prepare really well for the season of Christmas. There's a voice crying out in the desert, "Prepare the way of the Lord." Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now turn to God, our Heavenly Father, who hears the prayers we offer through his Son, the Prince of Peace, and through the Holy Spirit.
That the leaders of the church may continue to call people to turn away from sinful ways. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That men and women entrusted with authority will make justice flourish in our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That sinners may hear and take to heart the call to repent and to accept the mercy offered by God's only Son. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that all those in our community who endure suffering, rejection, or loneliness may find the fullness of peace in the coming of our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may see the salvation of God in his kingdom, especially Mary Abigail Pittman, Dorothy Sutak, Julian Roberto Fuentes and Julian Jose Fuentes, Martha Maria Suevas. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the soul of Roy Avila on this ninth day of the novena, praying for his soul. For Sandy Rivera on the second day of the novena, praying for her soul. For the health of Luis Sanchez, as requested by the intercession of the Blessed Mother. For the deceased members of the Catholic Daughters, CDA Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810. For Eleanor C. Noriega, Teresita Mestas, on the fourth anniversary of her passing, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, you desire us to be in peace, as in the Garden of Eden, as at the time of Noah on the ark, and at the Nativity of Jesus. May we prepare for the Prince of Peace through the Sacrament of Penance, Reconciliation, Confession, during our Advent mission tomorrow and Tuesday. Hear the prayers we voiced, those in the silence of our hearts. Grant them through your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn in your breaking bread, number 71, The King Shall Come.
Shall come when morning dawns and light triumphant brings, when beauty gives the eastern hills and life to joy awakes. Not as of old, a little child.
May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no mercies to plead our cause, no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue, with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Teresa, the Child Jesus, patroness of our diocese, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Mary Abigail Pittman, Dorothy Sutak, Julian Roberto Fuentes and Julian Jose Fuentes and Marta Maria Cuevas, the deceased members of our CDA Sangre de Cristo Court, 1810, Eleanor C. Noriega, Teresita Mestes on the 4th anniversary, Roy Avila on the 9th day of Novena praying for his soul, Sandy Rivera on the 2nd day of Novena praying for her soul, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Isaiah gives a prophecy of the lion and the ox eating hay. John the Baptist calls us to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. On the sacred altar, this Eucharistic table, Jesus offers us his body, blood, soul, and divinity, so that we may prepare for his coming in majesty, his coming in history, his coming now in these sacraments. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Jerusalem, arise and stand up on the heights, and behold the joy which comes to you from God.
Please join in singing in our First Communion hymn, number 67 in your Breaking Bread, Maranatha, number 67.
Oh. sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth, and hold firm to the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, tomorrow at 6 o'clock, our mission in Spanish. Tuesday at 6 o'clock, our mission in English, led by Father Carl Wharton. Confessions available after. If you're a San Luis Valley Federal Bank customer, please log on, and there's a link for the Spirit of Giving. And if you wish, ask them to donate a portion of $30,000 to Sacred Heart Church on your behalf. Thursday is a holy day of obligation, the Immaculate Conception. We'll have two masses, one at noon and the other at 6 p.m. Right? I think so. It's in your bulletin. I think it's noon and 6. My brother Knights invite you to the bingo this afternoon. The doors open at 3:30. The games start at 5. And every Sunday morning when we have faith formation for our children, we also have faith formation for us adults in English in the fireplace room, in Spanish in the catacombs right beneath us, okay? So there's also a schedule for the rest of Advent and through the new year. You'll be mailed this schedule soon, but if you'd like to take a picture and a screenshot, it's outside the central doors as you leave. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace.
Please join in singing our sending forth hymn number 601 in your breaking bread. Christ be our light, number 601.
To see.